Well, Peggy Williams Bookshop are lucky enough this afternoon to have an old friend of ours visit, Phil Cummings, who's just bringing out a new book called ANZAC Biscuits, which is due on the 1st of March. And Phil is a proud father of a 3-year-old and a 1-year-old. All I can say is, boom, bah, very loud. Because I tell you, I've read it a million times, mate. But give us the motivation behind ANZAC Biscuits. It's a beauty and we're looking forward to its release.
Yeah, so am I, James. I think the motivation initially was that my father actually served in the Second World War. For 4 years he was in the Middle East, and many nights we'd sit and he'd chat with me about it and tell me stories, and we used to look through a photo album that he has, that my sister now has, of all the photographs of him in front of the pyramids and riding all motorbikes and with his mates away at the war. He never told me horrible stories, only the funny ones. But I was sitting up one night, as you do, on quite late, probably 3 o'clock, and I had a cup of tea and some biscuits, and I had a blank page, but the agent had sent through a note to say, sort of listing some topics that I might like to have a go at writing about. One of them was ANZAC, the ANZAC tradition, and I balked at it initially because I didn't quite know how I was going to tackle it. But then, as I was eating these biscuits, some crumbs fell on the blank page. And I cannot describe or explain how this works, but that gave me the inspiration to sort of have the shifting of things from the little girl in the kitchen to the father away at war, because one of the initial pages is of the little girl taking the oats and dropping them like snowflakes onto a snow flower-covered table. And then we turn the page, of course, and the soldier, her father, is alone in the trenches with snow falling upon him. And so that, you know, started the contrast of working from home. But then I had to come up with concepts that would work in terms of what's going to happen at home that will fit with what the soldier is doing. Things like trudging through mud and the mixture of molasses and the bang and crash of the pots and pans on the floor with the explosion of gunfire.
Yeah, the page that you referred to before is certainly my favourite, and I think most of the people that have been fortunate enough to see the proof so far, it's one of their favourites. And I remember Rebecca and I doing the launch, or being involved with the launch of Winter's Blanket, probably a couple of years ago now.
Yes,
and you were like a kid in a candy store. You were so excited about about this book that you told us about, which of course got us pretty excited.
Yes,
too.
So, yes.
Sorry, I've just interrupted.
Yeah, no, that's done.
Yeah,
no,
go
no.
on again.
Yeah, no, that's right, because I was saying to Rebecca earlier that you never know what a story. When you work on a piece like this, you do it so many times, over and over again. Sometimes you lose the energy that you've put into it until you see someone else read it, or you tell someone else about it. And ever since I've been telling people about this, the reaction has been very similar. And you know, you sort of start to think, well, maybe this one's going to work. But of course, that also depends on, it's not only the text, it needs to be an illustrator that's going to make it work as well. And Owen Swan has done a wonderful job to bring it to what I wanted it to be, really. It was very exciting to see those first runs come back and thinking to myself, he gets it, he's got it, and it's going to be a good match.
Well, we've had a librarian in this afternoon that's seen the proof and teared up, and she'll be here at the launch on March the 8th.
Great.
So we're looking forward to that big time. And you've just done today also a session at Flinders Uni.
That's right, yes. I do an annual lecture there at to the year, fourth year education students who are going out to teach us, about 200 of them, I guess. And I was saying to Rebecca also that I felt that maybe the book affects only people of a certain age, and the young audience may not be as moved as perhaps someone of their age or my age. And and I said to her that, you know, someone of, you know, a 22-year-old girl read it and she cried too. Now, what her connection is, I'm not sure, but she just got to that last page and was overwhelmed to see the tin sitting there with some biscuits still remaining in it and the letter to the soldier. And it seems to be a common reaction for a lot of people, which sort of surprised me, to be honest with you. As I say, you get so close to a work, you know, sometimes you forget.
But we're saying before that most people have some sort of experience with war throughout their family. Mine is an uncle of mine served in New Guinea and for the Japanese there during the Second World War, and a young girl that I run with on Tuesday mornings with the South Australian Roadrunners groups got her partner's away in Afghanistan at the moment. So it spreads. I guess war is a horrible thing, and it spreads over over generations, and people, young and old, appreciate obviously the sacrifices that have been made. So,
but it's also that sense of separation, which I think hopefully the book covers. In that there are people at home that are desperately hoping that their partner or father or uncle or whoever it might be is going to be okay.
Yeah.
And I suppose there's a comforting thing that they're making these biscuits in the book to try and make sure that, or try and help themselves as much as anybody as well, to feel as though they're doing something towards making this person feel comfortable wherever they are, and knowing that they still care for them and are thinking of them all the time. But even in the research, there was also that sense of the people that were left behind and the things they had to do, particularly in the early wars, where women became farmers, and then in the Second World War they took on jobs in manufacturing and those sorts of things. That so the people that were left behind had a very important role to do as well.
And of course, in most of the cases, the mothers may not have only become farmers, they became fathers as well, because
yes.
For young boys or girls,
exactly.
That they were having to bring them up, and
it's something from my perspective, living the life I live, that I really can't imagine.
Yeah.
How that would be, my father certainly went through it, and I remember one of my proudest moments as a kid. He died when I was only 12 years old, but his medals, I remember wearing them. I was asked to wear them for an ANZAC march in my local town, and I was as proud as punch to walk with these medals. Obviously I hadn't done anything to deserve them apart from being a son of a returned serviceman, but it was a wonderful, proud moment. I've never forgotten that, and the ANZAC tradition was stamped in my psyche from that time, when all those memories that Dad spoke about, but also when the ANZAC Day came up, he was very keen to be in the march when he could.
Fantastic. We're looking forward to the launch on the 8th, and Owen's going to be here as well. So, for anyone that's seen this blog on Two Hoots from Peggy Williams Bookshop, we'll be doing a follow up to this, going through the process of bookmaking with Phil and Owen, probably in the week after the launch on the 8th of March. So, Phil, all I can say is congratulations. We're extremely excited about the book as well, and we've got. This month we've got ANZAC Biscuits as our book of the month on the website. So
Fantastic. Thank you very much.
If customers order one through the website, we'll send out a free poster to them that Rebecca's knocked up as well. It's got some information
on
both Phil and Owen on the back. So get your hands on a copy. And look, you hate to go out on a bit of a limb, Phil, but I think there's a good chance that this if it's not a notable book, I'll go here for Chasey. And I think it'll be fairly high up. I've seen a couple of very, very good ones this year, as I said to you the other day, and it's always a difficult choice for the judges, because any two people, you could look at 15 books, and any two people might choose a different lot of six. So it is a difficult thing to do, but I'd have it in my six.
Thank you. That would be a wonderful thing for me. Yeah. Thank you very much for having me along. It's been great to speak and talk about the book, because it's very dear to my heart, this one.
No worries, mate. Cheers.